Hi everybody, it's Camille from Butternut Soap Company, and we are back again. We're going to make more soap. Today I'm going to make one that I've been putting off for probably 9 months, so I figure I better use this fragrance oil. It's Black Raspberry Vanilla. Now, I've seen a lot of soapers make this, and it seems to be a popular fragrance. I can't stand it, but you know what? Other people seem to really like it, so... You know what? I'm going to make this. So I have my oils. I'm going to strain my lye because I have silk in here. What else did I put in here? I also have some sodium lactate and I put some sugar in it. Just for some more bubbles. And my oils are olive oil, coconut oil, lard, avocado oil, castor oil. I always do that, don't I? Anyway, yeah, I've got cocoa butter and shea butter. That's what I've got for oils in here. So, give it a quick stick blend. I'm going to move this closer so you can see a little better, I hope. And I'm soaping at about 100 degrees. I usually go room temperature, but it just felt like, I don't know. And I'm so scared that this fragrance, I don't know what it is. I'm afraid it's gonna accelerate really fast. Maybe I only think that because I haven't used too many of Nurture Soap's fragrance oils, but I know that two of them that I used, especially the Avalanche, made my soap solid so fast, so fast. So let's hope for the best here. I just want a thin trace. I'm going to do an in the pot swirl for this one. And my colors are just going to be black, red, hopefully red. I use a lot of really red. So we'll see how this goes. Okay, that's mixed enough. Oh, I wanted to mix in my clay. So no, it's not mixed enough. I always like to anchor my scents. I do like clay and soaps, but there are some times where my main purpose is just to anchor my scent a little bit. Come on. And actually, this clay, it's just white kaolin clay. I actually mixed this with some of my batch oil too. I usually just use water. I don't know why I used oil today. I just felt like it. Okay. Oh, you guys, I'm so scared that as soon as I add this fragrance, everything's going to go rock solid on me. Knock on wood. Creamy and nice. Oh, I love cold process. I really, really do. Hot process has its stuff too, but I just love cold process. Really love it. Okay, now here comes the scary part. What I usually do is I split up my colors, like split my batter up for my colors, and then I'll add my fragrance. And I'll some to each one, and it's kind of a guesstimate, right? And yes, even though I just finished saying I'm scared this is gonna accelerate my batter, I'm just gonna add it to the main batch, to this whole thing. And I guess we'll find out soon enough if it's gonna do anything. And I'm adding some vanilla stabilizer. To those of you who have never used it, when it says don't inhale this stuff, they are not joking. This is not a casual recommendation. First time I got it, I wasn't thinking twice. You know how you get all your soap supplies come in, smelling it, didn't give it a second thought, took a big whiff of vanilla stabilizer. I was coughing and hacking and my lungs were burning. It was bad. Who knew that stuff was that bad? Well, some people did. I now know. Oh, I'm so scared to do this. Okay, I'm just going to do it. Don't be afraid until you got something to be afraid of. You know, the more I smell it, the less I hate it. Don't absolutely hate it. Okay, well, my spoon is still moving. Or my spatula. Okay, and I'm gonna add this right now. Oh, I hate this stuff. I hate it. It is so bad. Vanilla content. You have to add vanilla stabilizer unless you want to just go with the fact that it's going to darken and go brown on you. Kind of like my caramel soap that I made there. All I did was add a little bit of titanium dioxide to one part of my batter and I just let it darken up. And so now I have two beautiful dark caramelly colors. But swirls and you're doing colors, you're gonna need some vanilla stabilizer. Otherwise, your beautiful colors are gonna turn ugly. Okay, you know what? We've still got some movement here. Woohoo! Yeah. Okay, I'm happy. And yes, I'm hand stirring. That's just fine with me. I'm hand stirring this fragrance in. Just in case. Call it terror. Call it whatever you want. I'm too scared that I'm going to turn my back for a second and I'll go, oh, what happened? Because that's never a good feeling. No. Okay. Ooh, cold process. I love you. Okay. And I'm learning to like this scent. Been smelling it for 2 days. I'm not learning to love it, but I'm learning to like it. So I think the majority of my color, I decided, is going to be, I really kind of want it to be red. Yes, and I'm going to stick with that. Do that. And I want less white. Okay. So, is that going to be enough white? Maybe a little bit more. Not much, though. There we go. Okay, so this will be red, this will be black, this will be white. So, let's add our red. Isn't that a gorgeous red? Can you see that? I'm moving away from me. I'm trying to get into the light. Look at that red. That's really red mica from... Geez, where did I get that from? I completely forgot. Maybe that's from Nurture too. I think it might be. I got it before Christmas for my peppermint soap. I really wanted some red in there, but I was too timid when I used it, so I still ended up with pink because I didn't want colored bubbles. So, nah, whatever. Ooh, hoo, 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 I love it. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Does that not make you just happy? Oh, that makes me happy. Look at that color. I'm excited. Okay, I'm excited about this soap. I was scared to get excited because I thought you're gonna get excited. And then what's gonna happen? You're gonna add your fragrance. Gonna be all disappointed. So I figured I wouldn't get my hopes up. My hopes are up. So if anything goes wrong now, yeah, I'll be upset. Because now I'm excited. Oh, look at that color. Yes. Yes. Okay, you can go there for now. You are going to be white. Don't know how much I'm gonna need for that, but let's just have a look. Because I don't want just an off-white. I want a punchy white. I want this white. Like the snow white. And that's not it. Let me have to stick blend this one. I feel like it's not really coming together the way I want it to. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna do it by hand. I'm just gonna end up with tons of air in there. And of course, all of you that soap know just how much, you know, you could have a great loaf of soap, but if three bars have that one really obvious bubble, just irritating because you just know it's there. Don't care what anyone says. If you're heavy into soaping, you're OCD to a certain degree. You have to be. I think you have to be. Maybe I know I'm not the only one. I know I'm not the only one. Because just from being in my Facebook soaping groups, I can tell, you know what? We're all pretty similar. Okay, that's more the white I'm going for. See that? So we got our white, we got our red, and now we are gonna get our black. I don't want that one. I want this one. And again, my black, this is activated charcoal. It's mixed in with some of my batch oils, which is why I'm trying to get all of it out. And you know, I want this to be super black. You know how sometimes you have to add a lot of activated charcoal to get it to be black instead of gray. Sure, it's not really black. I am just gonna toss some more activated charcoal in there and stick blend it in. Because I want my red to be red, my black to be black, and my white to be white. I don't want anything in between. So I guess we'll have a look, and I think we've got it. Ooh, baby, yeah, we've got it. Look, oh, I'm so happy. I promise I'm not gonna break out into song or anything. Maybe I shouldn't promise that. Oh, we say there's a chance tomorrow. What time is it now? I have no idea what time it is. I think it's like 8 at night. So I'll be definitely dipping into this tomorrow afternoon at 2 o'clock. I'll be checking it. Okay, who am I kidding? I'll be checking at 11:30. So that was a lie when I said I would wait till the afternoon. I can't help it. I'm impatient. Oh, look at these beautiful colors. Oh, I'm happy. I'm happy. I think black, raspberry, and vanilla. And I are gonna get along just fine. Look at that. Everything's still nice and fluid. which makes me a happy, happy girl. So, here. Oh, that's gonna look so good. Well, I'm sure it's gonna look so good. Okay, so I'm gonna do this. Oh, I'm creating shadows, eh? I'm gonna try to do it over here. Maybe you can see better. What I'm gonna do is go like that. I'm gonna go like that. I'm gonna basically go in four places. I'm gonna make just like on a dice dots like that. And then I'll do the same with the white. Okay. And I'll be doing that right over the black. I sure hope you can see. Maybe I need to move here. Can you see better? Sorry, I'm so two rock solids. I love these three colors together, and I kind of get that a lot of soapers use these three colors for this fragrance, but it makes sense. I tried to think of something else. You know, I was thinking maybe some purples and some hot pinks. But even those, it's been done. It's, I don't know. I think with this fragrance, you almost have to go with these colors because it suits the name so well. For this one, because I don't know what it smells like. I can't. Now, I'm debating whether or not I'm going to give this like one stir. Part of me wants to, but I don't know. What should I do? What do you think? Should I? Maybe I will. Maybe I'll give it like one full turn and that's it. And not touch it after that. Again, you know that I've been known to lie about that too. So, oh, I think I did there. I wanted to do here. And I'm using it all. So whatever the top looks like is what it looks like. I'm just going to have to, I don't know what I'll do. We'll see what it looks like. Put glitter on this. I just feel like with such punchy colors, you should have glitter. I don't know. Those are just my thoughts. I'm just trying to scrape everything out here. Oops. Okay, some there, 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 and I'll scrape it up for the last little dice mark. That's what I call it. I know that's just entirely made up, but that's what it makes me think of. Sorry, I know I'm totally blocking your view right now, but really I'm just pouring the last of the white into one spot. Okay, I'm just going to scrape this and get my last little, there's not much in here, but I can get it. Okay, I'm still debating. I said I might give it one turn. I'm still debating on whether I should do that or should I leave it alone. Oh, this shit, decisions. Okay, what do I do? Okay, one turn. One turn, a careful one. I'm just gonna go like that, and then like this. I don't know what I'm gonna do with this. I'm scared I'm gonna be all muddy if I. You're going in there. Okay, grab my mold. Look at that. Doesn't it look gorgeous already? Oh. Nike. And then all I have to do is pour. I put some on the side. I wonder what this is going to look like. I don't think I should have given it the stir. Don't I always say that at the end of stuff? That should be my catchphrase. I shouldn't have. I shouldn't have. I like the way that looks, though. I think that looks really cool. And since I can't waste this, I'm just going to carefully put it on the top. And I don't know exactly what I'm going to do with it. Like I said, I don't know what I'm going to do at the top. I think I'll just leave this skunk stripe in the middle and maybe see if I can't work something out with that. Okay, I still got more. So I really hope it turns out pretty. But again, like so many soaps, you know, they don't always turn out the way you plan them. But when you have a good solid soap recipe, you can still be happy about what you've accomplished, because it takes some planning and some thinking to have, you know, to come up with a really nice recipe. So if your vision doesn't turn out the way you wanted it, you still have some really, really good soap. Okay, I have to wipe this. Can't have that because that'll make me crazy. Okay, I'm going to turn around and bang this on the table behind me to get any air out. Okay, don't think there's any air in that. Okay, where's my skewer? Should I use a thick one or a thin one, or what should I do here? I feel like I could do something and I have time to do it too. I wonder if I just kind of, instead of doing my usual like figure eight, if I just kind of swooshed around and made S's everywhere. On to my last paper towel. Last one. I think this looks cute. I like it already. I don't think I'm going to do too much fussing with it. I think if I fuss with it, I'll end up getting mad that I fussed with it too much. Which happens about, oh, I don't know. I do like this end. I wonder what would happen if I went like that. I'm not touching it anymore. I don't know if you can see that. Does it look as... That end looks nasty, but I don't know how to fix that. So I don't think I want to get... Don't touch it, Camille. Stop it. But I feel like this could have a little more action on this side. I don't think I want to mess with that too much. So... What do you think? I hope you like it. Now it's time for glitter. Not a ton, just not a ton. Well, you know how it is. If you have used it before, you know, you always see that little spot. that doesn't seem to quite have as much as the rest. And before you know it, you're topping up every single inch of your loaf with glitter. So I'm just being thorough. Let's just say that. Okay, that's good enough. Okay, and what I'm going to do now is I am just going to cover it because I, for some reason, I never used to get soda ash on my cold processed soaps. Now I do. So I have to cover these soapers because I hate soda ash. And yep, there's a cure for it, you know, but if I can avoid it, I'm going to avoid it. And I'm also going to go put this outside in the porch where it's cold because of the sugar that is in here. Oh, please don't touch the top. I'm so scared it's going to touch the top. Oh, I love saran wrap and I hate saran wrap. It makes me think of getting duct tape in my hair or something. Oh, it's going to touch. Gentle. No, 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 no. Don't touch. You know what? I'm going to have to leave it on. I'm going to have to leave it on because I'm going to screw it up if I touch it anymore. Okay, got it. So there's my black raspberry vanilla. First time using this fragrance. It behaved beautifully. So thank you, Nurture Soaps, for an awesome fragrance that acted really well. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and also to leave me comments. Feel free to leave me comments. And we will see you, I guess, in a split second for the cutting of the soap. So we'll talk to you soon.